On today's episode, why the real robot revolution begins now. Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. We've all seen the videos of industrial robots assembling cars in auto plants. Large machines dropping large stampings into fixtures and robotically resistance welding stampings into bodies in white, sparks flying. Now that's a classic application for several reasons. For auto assemblers, robotics can handle large assemblies and spot weld them together with a high degree of repeatability. For workers, fixturing and welding large stamped panels was, and sometimes still is, difficult, dangerous, and boring work. But make no mistake, the automation was introduced primarily for productivity reasons. And in most cases, whether it's an auto assembly plant or an Amazon warehouse, the robots emulate what human workers do. So much so that an entirely new class of robots has been developed called collaborative robots, or cobots, designed to work without guarding next to humans with complete safety. So is the automotive industry the major user of global robotics? Well, surprisingly, no. Take a look at this Statista chart. For the latest full year worldwide stats, 2020, the electronics industry led the world industrial robot installation with 109,000 machines delivered worldwide. The auto industry is in fact in third place with 80,000 units shipped. Now we know that robots make sense in auto assembly, but electronics? Well, the reason why is more than just assembly of consumer electronics and handheld devices, a surprising amount of which is still done by hand. A major part of it is because of the way circuits are built today. It's called surface mount technology, and it uses very small, discrete electronic components and ICs that are reflow soldered on the surface of phenolic printed circuit boards, usually on both sides. This technology replaced the older through-hole technique, where components with leads or pins were inserted through perforations and were then wave-soldered to copper-clad tracks on the backside of the board. Now, SMT technology is lighter and allows far greater component density, but the real breakthrough offered by it is the ability to use pick-and-place robotics to stuff the boards. This SMTech pick-and-place unit uses 8 heads and can place as many as 20,000 components per hour. Now, unlike the automotive example, this technology doesn't replace human labor one for one, but it represents the only cost-effective way to mass-produce high-volume electronics today. Modern electronics are designed for robotic assembly and can't be mass-produced any other way. PCBs in mass-produced electronic devices are by nature small, and that makes this industry a natural for this kind of automation, but I expect that we're going to see something like this appear in everything from the automotive industry to order picking by major fulfillment centers, especially with majors like Amazon. But to make this change, the factories and the warehouses themselves, as well as the production processes, have to be redesigned to accommodate the machines rather than people. Now, these operations will not be collaborative. The only role for human beings will be to inspect and service the robots, and don't expect that to happen often. As political and supply chain pressures mount to reshore manufacturing from Asia to America, there is a brief window of opportunity post-COVID to design new, local production systems that are highly automated from the start, neatly working around the supply chain problem and the current shortage of skilled labor. The jobs that are created to support the automation will be skilled and well-paid. But what's to stop China or Korea or India from adopting the same technology? Well, nothing, which is the point. The clock is ticking, and this kind of industrial transformation will take capital and a lot of it. And it seems to me that this would be a natural place to direct a major Biden administration infrastructure policy. Bridges and roads, well, they're important, but the fact is, robots are probably more important. Well, that's it for today's episode of End of the Line, brought to you by engineering.com. If you like this show, be sure to subscribe to our channel and click on the notification bell for our next episode. For our deeper engineering video series for the manufacturing professional, visit engineering.com TV to watch exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future, not found here on our YouTube channel. The link is in the description below. Thanks for watching.